game day against Georgia. Yeah, let's just have fun with it. That's as easy as I can say. Georgia losing to South Carolina is the worst thing that could probably happen for Kentucky last week, because now Georgia's going to come out really, really mad today and want to prove a statement. So, yeah. Spread's 24.5. It's pretty nice, to be honest. But let's see what Kentucky can do. Sawyer Smith's back, but they're starting Lynn Bowden. And go Cats. This is going to be... Let's just have fun.
Kentucky, one of the worst defenses on third down, 114th in the nation, not ideal. Georgia's got a 3rd and 8 at their 11. Fromm's in shotgun, brings a guy in motion. Kentucky with the little two linebacker set. Fromm's going to step back. Kentucky not really getting much pressure. All the time in the world, and it was almost picked. Looks like Corker slipped, but they're going to have to punt. Big third down for the Wildcats defense. They need to get off the field. The offense for Kentucky had great field position last time. Couldn't take advantage of it. They gave the ball back to Georgia. Now we got Fromm and shotgun. Kentucky trying to get off the field here. This could be clutch. They're going to do a run. Interesting play call. And big Calvin Taylor, the Georgia native, sucks him down on the run. Interesting decision there by Kirby Smart. Not his best call. DeAndre square in on the tackle with Calvin. And Kentucky gets the ball back. Georgia's going for it here on 4th and 1. They have the best offensive line in the country, some say. They have the best running backs in the country, some say. Kentucky's strong suit to the team is the D-line. Power against power. Fromm under center. Fromm's going to take the snap. It looks like he's short. He's going to be short. The yes, Kentucky's defense is going to get off the field. It's going to be Kentucky ball. Big time stop. This is a huge 3rd and 13 for Georgia. They're trying to get points before halftime. Ball on their own 45-yard line. If Kentucky's defense gets a stop, it's a massive win for the Cats. But can they do it? Georgia brings a guy in motion. Fromm's going to take the snap. Quick drop. Kentucky hasn't got much pressure tonight, but they get a little there. And they're going to take him down. Big play by Boogie Watson to force the Georgia.
1st and 10. Kentucky's already got 2 first downs on the drive. They got 3 in the first half, so they're 1 away from their total in the whole half. Led's going to do a quarterback draw. Can he bounce? Good block by Rick. He does a nice juke. There he goes. He bounces to the outside. Lane gets another 1st down, and Kentucky's got a decent drive building. 3 first downs. Matches their first half total.
Look at this great play by the Wildcats defense. Why are you running on a 3rd and 5? Don't understand it, but Chris Oates just sniffs out the play and stops the running game of Georgia. Big play there. Georgia fans booing him off the field, as he should. I don't really understand what the offensive coordinator was doing in that situation. There's been some questionable calls. All right, Kentucky looks to be sending the house. Hopefully they can get some pressure. Georgia sends some guys in motion. All right, the snap. Pascal comes up the middle. Oh, and he gets a punt off. Will it be a good punt? Let's see. Josh Ali, he can't. Oh, he drops it. Oh, but he gets it back. Oh, but he fumbles again. Oh, and it looks like Georgia might have it. Georgia might have it there. Let's see what the ref says. Josh Ali, this would be the 2nd muff punt in 2 weeks, and then Kentucky recovers. Lucky play there for the Wildcats. They get away with one. Kentucky's punter does a 17-yard punt. Worst of the career. That was just horrible. And now Georgia's going to set up at the 39. They're going to run it to Swift. Swift's had some success on the outside edge. He gets it. He breaks one. He breaks two. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. 5. And he's in for 6. 1 play after the shank. How? What a shame. What a shame if you're a Kentucky fan. You've been playing your heart out all night. And your punter makes the worst punt you can possibly make. And the next play, you get a dagger into the heart. Unbelievable job.
Jake Fromm back there to take the snap. He does. He gives it to Heron. Heron's going to bounce off to the outside. Oh, terrible angle there by Jabari Brown. And Georgia's in for 6, and this game looks to be out of reach. About to be 14-0 Bulldogs. Kentucky gave it a good run the first half. Punter shanked one, really cost him the game, and now Georgia's going to walk out with the W.
Lynn Bowden in shotgun fakes. He's going to bounce to his left. Does Lynn have any room? Nice cut back there. He's got a 1st down and more. He's going to juke back in. That looks to be a face mask. Let's see if they call it, and they do. That 15 to the end of it. Kentucky's inside the 10 on a big Lynn Bowden run.
Georgia hasn't allowed a rushing touchdown yet this season. Only team in college football not to do it. Let's see if Kentucky can be the first. They're threatening. Lynn Bowden, he looks... All right, he's going to run. Looks like he is going to take off. Oh, no, he's going to throw back to the end zone. Oh, and Chris Rodriguez drops an easy catch for 7. What a costly play for the Wildcats. Hits him right in the hands, and he can't come down with it. That's not how you're going to pull off an upset, buddy.
Second and goal for Georgia. Ball at the 4. Fromm in shotgun. He's got DeAndre Swift to his left. They're going to bring the tight end in motion. Fromm takes the snap. They go right up the middle to Swift. Swift on a second effort gets in for 6. About to be 21-0 Georgia. Bulldogs with 6:24 left to go. Swift has about over 170 rushing, I want to say. 179, 2 touchdowns. Pretty good game. And Georgia is going to survive.
21-0, game over. Kentucky played a good half of football. Second half, it all went downhill when the number one punter in the nation, Max Duffy, who's averaging like 48, 50 yards a punt this whole season, shanked a 17-yard punt in his own territory. And when that happened, the game really just opened up. It was really bad, really bad. Georgia, in the next play, DeAndre Swift got a touchdown. It was just horrible. What you see from it is a Kentucky team that fought their heart out. You can't really be mad at them. Kentucky really put their heart and soul into everything they had tonight. The defense was unbelievable in that first half that kept them in it. The offense got shut out. And if you're going to score 0 points, common sense, guys. You're not winning the football game. No dip, but it's true. So it's unfortunate because Kentucky deserved better than that. But, hey, Georgia's the better team. We knew that coming in. I'm just Kentucky just played with unbelievable amount of effort and some heart. So if I'm looking as a Kentucky fan, yes, there's progress from this. You should be proud. But at the same time, next week, you're playing for your season. I'm going to call it as it is. Kentucky's 3-4 now. You play Missouri, who's coming off a tough loss against Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt's horrible. They're going to come out pissed off. They were just ranked this week. Kentucky, you're playing for your season. You really are. You don't want to be going. You're 3-4 right now. You're going to go 3-5. It gets real steep territory. The fan base, you know how it is. Basketball season's around the corner, but I'm proud of them. They played well. I'm going to call it out for Georgia. Georgia, your passing game's horrible. Georgia's passing game's horrible. Now, they have a bye week to go fix it for the Florida game, but if a Georgia fan expects them to win the championship right now, it's not realistic. They gotta get their passing game together. What good do you see out of this game? You beat Kentucky 21-0. Kentucky completed 2 passes the whole entire game. If you're a Georgia fan, you got to be a little worried. Defense was unreal, as you know, but you're also playing a fifth-string quarterback. But so at least their defense is a strong suit, but Georgia's offense on the bye week, you just got to get it together. But look, I think Georgia's going to be fine, but it was conditions were a little crazy. But if you like the video, Macklin Sports, like, subscribe, go follow the TikTok, Macklin Sports 419. Go Cats, keep supporting, and peace.